Hey guys, so here are Sue and today with the Delapine Lego Blink Iron Man 8-pack minifigures. So you can see, it's Iron Man set by Delapine. So it's recommended for just Firecraft, and this set, the LP9045, comes with 8 minifigures, of course. And yeah, so you got Superior Iron Man, Mark 46, this is Mark 35 or something, I'm not sure, but yeah, Mark 39, which is the Gemini, and yeah, so you got the Mark 17 Heartbreaker, this is the Mark 32 Romeo, and the Mark 20 Python, and you also got the last one here, you also got the Mark 33 Silver Centurion. So these are all of the tops of the boxes, which shows you the minifigure and also you know, the side builds. But yeah, I won't be showing them because yeah, it takes a lot of time, and yeah, this video will probably be like 1 hour or something. But yeah, I will only be showing you the big build, which is a big stamp. So yeah. Oh, these are the sides of the boxes, which shows you how to build the figure. So this is the other side of the box, shows you the figure. So this is the bottom, they are all the same, and so as the back, which shows you the big build and also the full set of minifigures. But yeah, this big build is a big rotating stand, which I'll show that later. So yeah. So this is the instruction manual here to show you how to build the stand and also the side build. So yeah, I'm gonna just speed it up to not make it very long. So yeah. So that's it. So the first figure here is Superior Iron Man. So this figure is probably like the most detailed figure in the set or like ever, because you know, it's like, it has a lot of printing. But yeah, so you can see you got the studs and the cylinders to make it look like he's flying, and you know, he doesn't have his helmet. Instead, this is his a mask one, and you can see you got his hair there. Let's just remove that. But you can see you got his face, and yeah, so the torso printing looks very good. You got the arc reactor right there, and yeah, so the leg printing looks good too. And yeah, so there's a side arm printing, which is really nice. Side torso printing, which is like really great. And yeah, side leg printing. Like yeah, pretty much the whole figure, there's like printing everywhere. So that's great. And yeah, so the back, you got the back torso printing, and you also got the back leg printing, which is also really nice. And yeah, so like yeah, that's really it for Superior Iron Man. So overall, it's a very nice figure. So next is the Mark 46. So yeah, you can see you got studs and cylinders, of course, for a flying effect. And you know, you can see he does not have his helmet, but it's instead like the face printing is there's no face printing because the headpiece is just the helmet. So yeah, that's nice, I guess. But you know, so the torso printing looks really good. You got the arc reactor there, and you got all the blue like dots and everything. And yeah, so the leg printing looks really good too, and you got all the black lining. So yeah, and you know, like every single figure in the set has a side arm printing, which is probably like the highlight of the set. So you know, this is the back printing, looks pretty similar to the official Lego figure. So speaking of the official Lego figure, this is the official Lego figure. It's not quite though, it's the Shengyang Mark 46. But yeah, so this is just a quick comparison of it. So you can see the arc reactor, it looks so totally different. And also the helmet, the eyes there, there's like a little bit of like blue printing outside the outline. So you know, it just looks much more accurate. And this helmet is just like It's just a normal helmet. And yeah, so the light green thing, it's just the Mark 43 one. And this one is, yeah, it looks very good. So this is the back. And yeah, it looks pretty similar. So yeah, that's it for Mark 46. So this is Iron Man Mark 35 Red Snapper. So I won't be talking about these studs and the cylinders again, but you know, so you can see the helmet printing looks very good. You got that white eyes and also the red marking, you know, looks pretty normal. And yeah, so the torture printing, you got this rectangle arc director, which is a nice shape. And you also got these like metal, like, I don't know, these like rods or something, I guess supporting the suit. I'm not sure how it supports it, but yeah, so the leg printing is not so interesting, looks weird, but you know, so the side arm printing, it's pretty nice too. But yeah, like the actual suit is actually much bigger than this, so yeah, it's not so accurate, this one. And yeah, it has some stuff on his arms too, so you know, like they didn't include it, any of it, so yeah, that's kind of sad. But yeah, so this is the back torso printing. You got more of those metal rods. And yeah, so yeah, let's compare it to the Shingon version of the Red Snapper. So the Shingon version is like much simpler, but I do like the leg printing of the Shingon's Red Snapper. So yeah, I don't think this, I'm not sure if this is accurate or not, the Shingon one, because yeah, the colors, like just developing, you have different like red colors, so you know. But yeah, so the Delapine one is definitely a much better, much detailed one. So yeah, like that's it for Mark 35 Red Snapper. So the fourth figure here is the Mark 39 Gemini. So this is a spacesuit for Iron Man. And yeah, so you can see the hip printing looks very good. You know, you got the gold and the eyes and everything. And yeah, the torso printing, you got this like kind of special, kind of more like a unique shape of arc character. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And yeah, so the leg printing is also nice too. And yeah, so this is the side arm printing. Yeah, you just got some armor printing. And yeah, so the back, you got these like kind of, they're kind of like jetpacks, I guess. Yeah, it's supposed to be a spacesuit, so you need extra crust and everything. But yeah, you got all like the crusters and everything. And yeah, and it's pretty detailed. I do like it. It's pretty cool. So yeah, like overall, this is like one of my favorite minifigures from the set. So yeah, that's it for Mark 39 Gemini. So the fifth figure here is the Mark 17 Heartbreaker. So this one is pretty recognizable because Lego made it before. And yeah, in the Iron Man Cree, it is you know, it's like the leader of like the all the Iron Man suits. Like it's one that is leading all the Iron Man suits. So yeah, that's nice. So you can see the helmet printing, you know, you got the blue eyes, which is, you know, pretty accurate. And yeah, there are like some like scratch marks, so you know, that's kind of sad. But yeah, so the torso printing looks very good. You got the like the arc director right in the middle. And yeah, it has like blue lining outside of it, which, you know, kind of makes like a arc character effect. And yeah, you know, this suit actually has like much more powerful like uni beam thing, so yeah, that's cool. And you know, like this middle part, it has a lot of armor and everything, you know, to make the uni beam more powerful. So yeah, the leg printing looks nice too. And yep, so the side arm printing is not quite interesting, but you know, pretty simple. And yeah, so this is the back printing, looks nice. And yeah, so let's compare it to the official Lego figure. But I don't have the official Lego figure. I only have this one from Shingon. But yeah, it's pretty accurate. So you know, the helmet is accurate enough. But yeah, the official Lego one just looks pretty weird, but yeah, so the torso branding is totally different. Like the Delapine one just looks much better, and yeah, the Shengyang one, you just have this blue, like this dark blue as the arc reactor. You know, it's not like light blue, because if that thing is in light blue, it'll look better. But yeah, so the light printing, it's actually pretty similar, and you know, the back, yeah, they're completely different. So yeah, and you know, so that's it for Mark 17 Heartbreaker. So the sixth figure here is the Iron Man Mark II Romeo. So it's just basically a like a repaint of the Mark 17 Heartbreaker. And yeah, so you can see the helmet printing, you know, it's pretty basic. You know, you got the silver plating, and yeah, so the torso printing looks pretty good. You know, you got an arc reactor right there, and yeah, so a lot of armor printing, and you know, it does have some leg printing, and yeah, so the side arm printing, they're pretty cool, and yeah, this is the back printing, looks good. And yeah, so that's really it for Mark 32 Romeo. So the seventh figure here is the Iron Man Mark 20 Python. So I'm not sure how this suit works, but you know, it looks you know, nice. And yeah, so the helmet printing is just a gold plating, and yeah, so the torso printing, you got some armoring, and you know, you got the arc reactor right there in the middle, and yeah, the leg printing looks nice. Side arm printing, you know, just some gold printing, not much going on there. But yeah, so this is the back printing, looks pretty similar to all the other suits. And yeah, so that's it for Mark 20 Python. Last but not least, this is Iron Man Mark 23 Silver Centurion. So obviously LEGO has made this figure before, so yeah, I'm going to compare it to the like official LEGO figure later. But yeah, so you can see the helmet printing is just the silver helmet printing, nothing too special there. But yeah, the torso printing, you got the arc reactor right there and some armor plating and stuff. So yeah, this is the light printing, looks nice. And yeah, side arm printing, you got some armor printing right there, not much else going on. And yeah, so this is the back, this part there looks really similar to all the other Mark III suits that all other like brands that have made it. But yeah, so here's a comparison to the LEGO version. Technically this is the Shengyang version, but yeah, it's still pretty accurate. So you can see the Shengyang version, he has the armor there. So you know, like the Shengyang one, like the arc reactor just looks much better. And you know, you can see you got some of these like side like wings or something, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, so the back, you know, this part here looks pretty similar. And yeah, so let's remove it. Let's just remove all this. And yeah, see the torso printing under here. So like the torso printing under the like official LEGO's version of Mark 23 is you know, much better. And yeah, the leg printing is much more detailed. Like it does even have like a side leg printing. And you know, like the side arm printing, like the Shengyang version is just much better. So you know, and the back comparison, and yeah, the back of this Shengyang one is just much more detailed. So yeah, like that's really it for all of the Iron Man figures. So this is the display stand built here. So you can see it's on a turntable. So under here you can see you got this Technic pin piece, or you know, just this piece right here connecting this whole entire thing. And you know, like if I just put it back, you can see the top here, you can see this one does also spin. And yeah, so each part right here, you can see you got little place to put the Iron Man figures. And yeah, so the bottom ones, they are only like one brick piece. And yeah, the top ones, it has a Cree brick piece to make it that they're like flying higher and everything. And it's pretty cool, I guess. And yeah, so the middle, you got this tile piece to support the whole thing. And yeah, so like that's pretty much it for the stand. So let's put all the Iron Man figures on. So here are all the Iron Man figures in the set on the stand. So you can see they do look pretty cool, and each of these parts, they are all connected by this clip piece. And you can move them, up and down to make them like they are flying or anything. And it just looks so really great. And you can just spin it around and just look at them. And yeah, so the top four, like the top ones, they are the ones that I like from the set. And yeah, the bottom ones, they are the ones that I don't quite like them. They are not the they are my least favorite of the set. But that's really it for all of the builds of the set. So overall conclusion of this set, so how do I think of it? Well, the set here, like the figures, they are all just really great, really detailed, especially Superior Iron Man. He's really detailed from the figure, like the whole figure is like just really detailed. And like the rest of the figures is really nice to get them. Like most of these figures you already get them in like normal form made by other brands like Biku or Shengyuan. But yeah, this one is really special, really unique. They don't have their helmet pieces. Instead, the helmets, they are just printed on the head piece. That's so really cool. And yeah, so the build here is nice. The display stand, I do like it. And you can display all your Iron Man figures flying around. And yeah, that's great. And the turning feature is a little bit annoying, but it's still pretty good. And yeah, I like how you can just pose all the figures, make them like kind of flying and everything. And yeah, that's just really great. So overall, I do recommend you getting the full set for the stand and also all the figures. And yep, so the whole set is just a really great set. So yeah, buying so this down in the description box below, along with all my social media pages down in the description. So if you want to join Physical Alternative Freaks, I'll put a link down in the description box below as well. But thanks for watching, I'll be seeing you very soon.